Third and final day of the 2017 Paradise Jam here inside the Vine Center, and the Liberty Flames get a win today, 84-72 over Quinnipiac alongside the Snazzy, Paul Nazigan. My name is Nick Pierce. And, Paul, it was good to see the Flames come out here and bounce back. It's never easy when you got to play three games in 3 days, but the Flames were able to overcome a halftime deficit, take control of this thing in the second half.
Yeah, a few things were against them. You know, you mentioned three games in 3 days, but then also, you know, coming off a tough loss the night before, you know, they lose at the buzzer to Houston, hard-fought game. And then playing the noon game on Sunday, that's just atypical of your schedule. That's usually an off day. So more impressive then to come back, take the court with a lot of energy and fight and, you know, battle a good team in Quinnipiac and come away with a victory.
Check out some of the highlights from this one. Lavelle Cabell today with 19 points, but it was Scotty James leading the way with 21, career high for him in his young career. 8 rebounds for Scotty as well today. Flames had 3 scorers in double figures, not just Cabell and James, but also Georgie Pacheco-Ortiz. Another nice game for him. 12 points today, 2 assists and no turnovers. Nice game for Georgie. Nice weekend for him.
Yeah, a lot of good stats on that seat. A lot of guys that you mentioned getting the action today. You know, Scotty James did 2 things. You mentioned his points, but he had a tough assignment defensively guarding Chase Daniels, who is an outstanding player. And so he had to do it on both ends, and Scotty really made a great effort on both ends of the floor, scoring defensively. And then Lavelle really picked it up in the second half. You know, the game was in the balance. I think right midway through the second half, he hit those 2 back-to-back threes that kind of gave Liberty a boost, some scoring and some excitement, and they pushed it on out for the victory.
Yeah, 7 ties, 10 lead changes in this game here today. But the Flames come out on top as they go 1-2 on the weekend here in the Paradise Jam. Afterwards, we did have a chance to catch up with the head coach of the Flames, Richie McKay, and some of the Flames players.
I thought this game was going to be difficult. I think Quinnipiac has great offense, and they have some really talented players. And we were coming off of 2 emotional losses, where I think immature teams or inexperienced teams may have left one on the table. And our guys looked like we were headed that direction in the first half, but really reeled it in the second half, defended a little bit better, started moving the ball a little bit better, and as a result, we end up getting the win. This whole tournament is good for our team. Look, we are embarking on something different. We're trying to challenge ourselves in a way, play against people that are potential NCAA tournament teams, and improve our program and our brand. So this tournament was, we got exactly what we wanted, except we didn't win all 3. But we played Houston in such a competitive manner, and we shoot a little bit better against Mercer. Maybe there's a different outcome, but a lot of respect for Mercer. They're arguably the best team in this tournament, but we learned from that one on Friday and the one from yesterday, and I thought it was reflective in today's play.
Manero, a tough opponent, so we have to do a lot of film and getting ready for it. But we do our defense, what we pride ourselves on, and it's the same no matter who we play. So we just can always know we can fall back on that regardless of the opponent that we're playing. We're just trying to pick my shots wisely, just trying to get downhill on their defense and put as much pressure on the rim as possible. And my teammates were able to find me on a couple of threes that I knocked down. So I was just a beneficiary of them finding me with open space.
We just kept playing as a team. We knew just had to keep fighting. They kept coming at us. We came out at an early lead, and they just kept coming. And we ended up building a little bit lead at the end and keeping on to it. I think it's always good to have adversity. Adversity is a blessing. So they just kept coming, and we just kept responding. So it's good to see from our guys.
All right, Flames a winner today, 84-72 over Quinnipiac. And Naz, a couple of things really stick out here looking at the stat sheet. First of all, rebounding. Flames plus 12 today on the glass. Excuse me, plus 11 today on the glass. All 11 of those rebounds, offensive. Today for the Flames. A lot of second chance opportunities here today as well.
Yeah, Scotty James was just all over the glass, something that, you know, again, we talked about the depth that the Liberties are going to enjoy this year with his addition on the interior, but not just with scoring, but if he's not corralling a rebound, several times today he was able to poke it away to another Flames player, so active on the glass, and that's spreading too. You know, we see Ezra, we see Isaiah Williams, Mayo, really just those guys just really providing some offensive rebound that they didn't have a year ago.
All right, so with the win, Flames go to 3-2 on the season. Liberty 1-2 on the weekend here in this tournament, but certainly good growing experience for this team going forward, seeing some very talented teams here, and I think the Flames definitely got better defensively as well, seeing some really talented scorers. So 84-72, your final score. Liberty a winner over Quinnipiac. For Paul Nazigan, my name is Nick Pierce for the Liberty Flames Sports Network.